Hey everybody, today I'm going to be showing you my Ableton live looping setup. Now I already made a video on how I do the looping in Ableton, so if you're curious on how that works, I will leave a link in the description. Today's video is going to be more about my specific setup and the different gear that I use. So let's start with the audio interfaces that I use. I'm actually using two of them, and they are both Presonus Fire Studio Project interfaces. Each of these interfaces has 8 inputs, and I have them daisy chained, meaning I can use up to 16. This is really nice for live looping because you can use a lot of different instruments and microphones. So even though I can have up to 16 inputs, I usually don't use nearly that many. So in a typical session, I will usually have a bass plugged in direct to the interface, and then a microphone on my guitar amp, and then a few other mics that I use for percussion, like shakers and tambourines and bells. And then for the drums, I'm using 3 different mics. I have one on the kick, one on the snare, and one as an overhead. I also usually use my MIDI keyboard, but since that is just MIDI USB to the computer, it doesn't take up an audio input on my interface. So that's pretty much everything I use for instruments and microphones. Now I'll show you what I use to control Ableton. The main MIDI controller I'm using is the Akai APC40. I use this to arm tracks and control levels, as well as control effects that I have mapped to the different knobs. To actually punch in and out of the loop, I'm using a Behringer FCB1010 MIDI foot controller. This controller has 10 different buttons with 10 banks, so there's a lot you can do with it, but I usually just use one of the buttons to act as a loop pedal. So that's the controller that I use to loop the different instruments over in this area, like the guitar and bass and bells and percussion. What I do for the drums is a little different. Right next to the kick drum pedal is a different foot switch that my brother made for me. It's basically just a momentary foot switch, and you could actually use a keyboard sustain pedal to do the same thing. So the cable from the foot switch runs all the way back to the APC40 and is plugged into the foot switch 1 input. In Ableton, this automatically maps to launch scenes. So the way I use this is I will arm the drum tracks and then walk over to the drums and use the foot switch to launch the scene. So when I loop the drums, I have to play for the full length of the loop. If I try to loop just one bar within a 4-bar loop, it will start the whole loop over when I try and punch out instead of playing the rest of the loop. So that's why whenever I loop the drums, I always play for the full length of the loop before punching out. But with the Behringer controller mapped to the session record button, it's really easy to do different length loops. For example, if my entire loop is 4 bars long, I could punch in and do a 1-bar shaker loop and then punch out. So I think that's pretty much everything about how my live looping setup works in Ableton. If you have any more questions, please feel free to let me know in the comments, and thank you for watching.